My name is Tiago Hacke, and today we are shooting another plein air video here in Cresmina Beach near Guincho. Guincho is one of the most beautiful beaches on the Lisbon area, and we're going to be painting on watercolor paper with acrylics. And the landscape I want to catch today, to capture, it's going to be that rock there. It has this kind of ochre brown colors with the fisherman's on the top. I'm not sure yet how I will draw the fish, I will paint the fish on it, but we'll see. This is painting as you go. And I got, as always, here my English box of chocolate box of acrylic paints. Full of sand from the last expedition. The palette, this time I got a bigger palette. Still have some scraps of paint, and for the colors that I will use today, I'm going to use the green blue for the ocean. I'm going to try to get that depth sign, feeling on it. I'm going to go for the ochres, the brown, dark brown, some cream colors. The sky is going to have a lot of blue and gray, and I think it's starting to rain, so I need to hurry up with the colors. So acrylic is a little bit water, as everyone knows already. I got here my Van Gogh painting station box, which I might use just as a palette today. It's more steady. I have a small stool here. I'm gonna get the stool. It's gonna be very handy. The stool can fit here my stuff and materials. Got some old rags. I didn't clean the box since last time I went painting. It's a mess, you know. I'm sorry. And I'm gonna use a broad brush. Today I'm gonna use a slightly different brush. I'm going to try to do the main things with this brush, it's way thicker and bigger, and then I'm going to add some details with a small brush. So today I'm going to try to go broader and faster. I always say that I'm trying to go fast, not because of the rush, but it's because of light change. Today light change will not be so evident, because will not notice so much the light changing, because there is a big pack of clouds on the top of us, and in a way it helps us because the sun is not gonna shift so much the shadows on the horizon, and it's not gonna have such a big impact on the difference of the colors, because there is no sharp shadows today. Also, why I am rushing today is because it's 7:30, it's almost 8 p.m. And here the lights go, the sun goes down at 8:45, I think. So I have about 1 hour and 20 minutes, 1 hour and 15 minutes to paint. I'm going to try to use less than that, because the last moments the sky is going to be very different already. The sun is going to hit the horizon, then it's going to, as soon as it's under the clouds, it's going to show some layers, some different colors, and I want to try to paint this environment, this cloud environment, as we are seeing it now. So you probably noticed on my Instagram or my YouTube, you can see that my Instagram, Tiago Hacke, H-A-C-K-E, my family name. Not because I'm the hacker of the paint, and I'm not bringing you crazy hacks, it's just my family name, because I'm half German. And some people think, as I do a lot of murals and street art type of work, some people think it's my tag. And so I also started using it as my tag. Because I thought, why is it covering up my real name? Okay, so I'm mixing the two blues now, and I'm going too dark on the valleys, but I'm not worried, because I want to make a cloudy atmosphere. And I'm going to cut with the whites now. Wet brush, white paint. And now I'm going to play with these shapes. It's important that the clouds that I can see with nuances and tones of color inside the clouds, because they are never really totally gray. And this they have a bit of blue, a bit of kind of purple. I'll try not to include that mechanic building there. I don't know why, I don't like it. It's too much contrast, so maybe I'm gonna change reality. I went all in gray just for the convenience of having this here. But I think I should stretch it. This is just some loose drawing. I'm not worried about mistakes now, and I'm not worried about the real colors of the rocks, because I'm gonna work more on the ocean, and I want to not contaminate my I don't want to contaminate my palette with the with tons of yellow once I'm playing with blues, because then everything's gonna get green. So I mix the black, my grey basically, with more blue, and this phthalo kind of emerald blue. It looks correct here, but it's not. It's slightly lighter, and this is very normal, that when I'm mixing it seems fine, and when I put it on the canvas, it's not. On the surface. In this case it's watercolor paper. Because the eye only sees contrast and values in comparison. We cannot have the... We do not have the capacity of seeing values like just as they are and getting them totally correct. It always has to compare with what's next to it. And like that, sometimes we paint in a way and then we change, because in comparison, the values... Let's phrase it differently. It matters more that the values are correct compared to the ones closer and to it in the picture than if they are really correct according to reality. Because the scale of values is what's gonna bring the realness of the image. Now, as I go down, I'm going to start mixing this greenish blue. Lots of white, because I had too much paint on the brush. Normally I paint with way too much paint. But in the end I really like this impressionistic style. So I'm not really worried. And I like the paintings to be very thick. Like me. Ochre is way more creamy, more towards the brown. I start to need some magenta. Balance out the red. Get a bit of purple in the sky as well. That is way too much. This area I'm gonna get a lot back and forth. That's what I'm seeing already. I'm gonna get back and forth until I get it right. Thank you. lot of white houses.
A lot of white houses.
But it's already 3 blocks of white in different areas. Mix it with the colors. So I can see if I get this good. Now the color of the sky is reflected on the ocean as well. It's starting to rain, so I'm gonna hurry up with this and I'm gonna just do the ocean as fast as I can, painting in rain. I mean, we're gonna mess up my painting and start squalling. Gonna triple over. I don't use a smaller brush. I need to take this front thing out. Burnt sienna offer is the burnt amber. So no color is here unless maybe the burnt amber. All gonna be pretty dark. All gonna be very nice. Then you decide which time of the wave, which part of the wave I decide to paint. Something's gonna heavy or something. Follow the way. Then it's part of the way that I'm gonna get to the city. There's a bride there. good or in the front? Pretty good actually. It's just misty for me. I don't know if you can see it coming from the road. I'm actually feeling the raindrops. brush is really good to do clean cut drawing text. Okay, we're back on. These cameras only permit me to film 30 minutes. But the painting is almost finished and I have not much battery left, so I'm gonna speed up. Okay, now I need to clean my water. I'm gonna grab another container. So I'm gonna work on the whites and the sands, and the painting is gonna be finished. I might still use the white as much as I can. And when the brush gets dirty, I start using it for the sand. The wet rocks. So I'm gonna have to clean it every time and then dab it in the white. White. I'm gonna try to do the foam with the white so as pure as I can. It's gonna be messy. going to be challenging. Those colors mix really fast. This is cool if I leave a lot of texture, that would just give an amazing aspect to the painting. Funny because the moment now I'm stopping way at the same time. I'm stopping and I have picked a grasp only a moment on the wave. Because it's always moving, so I have to decide, okay, it's in this part when she's the wave is there. And then each wave is slightly different. The splash, the effects can be slightly different. Okay. I think it's pretty much done.
It was actually faster than I thought. I'd like to change some stuff here in the sky, but I can't see it. How it's different now. Maybe. Because I remember we couldn't see so much the brush blocks. And maybe if they are a sharp dark line. Make those cuttings on the rock there. I'm gonna sign it and we are done for today. I hope you like it. You will be able to find this painting or others on sale, other plein air paintings, on my Etsy account. It's Tiago Hacke Artist on Etsy. You'll find the link below in the description. And I hope you enjoyed. This place is called Praia de Cresmina, Cresmina. And here, Guincho. Beach, one of my favorites in Cascais, Portugal. Yeah, notice that the area with more contrast, I try to put it here, the central focal point. So I put the darkest darks there, except the cut area. But here is the biggest contrast of light and dark, and sharp and smooth. And it's where I want it to be, the central focal point. It's the most important area in any painting, where the eye is directed to. So I hope you enjoy it. The colors here are very different from what I've painted on other paintings. And I'll try to keep changing so it's more challenging. I'll do some forest ones. I was already investigating some places around here to paint plein air on some forests. There is a lake in the forest that looks really cool. And those I'm gonna paint like around noon so I get sharp, deep shadows. And we got some variation, you know. I did a lot like towards the sunset, and now I'm gonna do some ocean painting, some seascapes, that's how we call this type of painting. And after, I'm gonna do some forests. It's not gonna be in this order. The order is gonna be according where here, for example, I can only paint when there is no wind. It's actually quite rare that there's no wind in this area. But yesterday I passed by here, I saw there was no wind, so I knew that today was a good day. And one more session of plein air painting with Tiago Hacke. Follow me on Instagram, Facebook, subscribe, all that crap that you hear on every YouTube channel. You know you are helping me to do it. And if you like to purchase a painting or a painted t-shirt, now I'm doing painted t-shirts. And I got a few commissions on them. You're more than welcome, just ask me, DM me, or check on my Etsy account. You can also check me, send me a DM on Facebook or Instagram. Take care, my name is Tiago Hacke, incredible artist from Cascais. And this is the area we are at. There, it's normally a mountain over the sea, but the cloud range is so big that you can't even see it.